Hi there, my name is Natalie, and I hope my story is helpful for many people. It's about me fighting and defeating my severe performance anxiety. I was extremely interested in music from a very young age. Whenever I went outside as a child, I'd take a stick or something and rub it on fences, trees, benches, and on anything else I saw. I loved discovering new sounds. I also loved watching people masterfully play various musical instruments on TV. But the most attractive of them all was the huge, beautiful, melodious grand piano. That was what I told my parents. Without hesitation, they signed me up for a group piano class. And they gave me a synthesizer for my birthday. Ecstatic, I started practicing eagerly. It was going great! I quickly learned to play simple songs and decided I wanted to go to a real music school, not just a group class. On the 1st of September, mom took me to enroll at the school, but there was one issue. I was 9 years old at the time, and our local music school normally accepts 5 or 6 year olds. Mom and I went from one piano classroom to another, but the different teachers all gave us the same response. Actually, children start at the age of 6 here. They didn't care that I already had some music experience, probably even enough to play better than their 9-year-old students. None of the teachers wanted to enroll me in their class. I was very upset. I thought, I guess I'm just not meant to study here. But mom cheered me up. There was actually one less teacher left to talk to. When the teacher saw me and heard I was 9 years old, she didn't straight up reject me like all the others. She asked me all about my experience and watched me play for a bit. And she accepted me. My dream of going to a music school came true. I was on cloud nine. But it wasn't as simple as I had thought. They were keeping me so occupied, I barely had the time for my regular homework. I could spend hours at the piano learning sophisticated melodies. Regular school, music school, and my volleyball practice combined were almost an unbearable load. But my work was not in vain. My family and friends supported and appreciated me. One day, my piano teacher offered me to perform at a concert. I happily agreed because I had never played on stage before. So picture this. After rehearsing for many days, I'm finally standing off stage ready to perform. Memories are flooding my mind. Rehearsing, preparing, memorizing the notes, picking out a dress with my mom. I can't let everyone down. My thoughts are racing and anxiety overcomes me. That's when they announce my name. As I enter the stage, my heart is pounding. My arms and legs are shaking, my head is spinning, and I realize I forgot how the composition starts. Anxious and frightened, I take my place at the grand piano. It's awfully quiet. All eyes are upon me. I play the first chord, and I hear a false sound. I realize it was a wrong chord. I play another one, also wrong. I actually panic. It takes me 3 tries to finally start playing. One mistake goes after another, dozens of wrong notes in a really short piece. When I finished playing, I got up to take a bow, but I was so nervous at that point that I just ran off the stage in tears. It was a disgrace. I never thought I'd mess up like that with 100 people watching. I decided I would never perform again. Thankfully, both my teachers and my parents supported me. They told me stage fright is normal and it goes away with experience. Also, I shouldn't worry about wrong notes that much. People in the audience are just as human as I am. Even if a piano player makes a mistake, nobody will even notice it if she doesn't give it away. That gave me some strength and confidence. Fast forward 5 years in the music school. I had played at multiple concerts and competitions. I had learned to smile at the audience to feel confident and calm. I had gradually defeated my stage fright completely. It was now time for my first international competition. As I performed, I wasn't anxious, but instead tried to enjoy it. I played the piece brilliantly. It was the first time I actually won a contest in spite of making a mistake. People really didn't even notice it because I just continued playing with a smile on my face. That was an unforgettable experience that really drove it home for me. I should never be afraid of performing. Enjoying it is the key to success. I have now graduated music school and I'm learning to play guitar. I can say years of education have not gone in vain. I feel at home on stage now, like a fish in the water. If you experience stage fright, I hope you can overcome it so that performing only brings you fun and joy. Would you like to see more episodes? Support us by hitting like and subscribe. If you want to see your story in one of our videos, send it to this email address.